But like his predecessors, Mr. Trump is gradually learning that for all its talk about cooperation, China is deeply reluctant to take any measures that could seriously destabilize the North Korean government for fear the country might collapse or be absorbed by the South. So China's strategy has been to buy time and preserve the status quo with talks that may be linked to some kind of testing freeze. They may now have a new advocate of that approach, President Moon Jae-in of South Korea, who was elected on a platform pledging resumed engagement with the North. On Tuesday, he embraced a similar idea, telling Nora O'Donnell of CBS News in an interview that a freeze could be a way station to a second phase of talks that would achieve the complete dismantling of North Korea's nuclear program. In an interview broadcast on Wednesday, the North Korean ambassador to India, Kai Chun-yong, said his country was willing to consider a moratorium on nuclear and ballistic missile tests if the United States and South Korea stop their annual joint military exercises. Under certain circumstances, we are willing to talk in terms of freezing nuclear testing or missile testing, Mr. Kai said, speaking in English. For instance, if the American side completely stops big large-scale military exercises temporarily or permanently, then we will also temporarily stop. Let's talk about how to solve the Korean issue peacefully. But to American officials, a freeze is a trap that previous administrations